Ohio State squaring off against Penn State, 7:30 p.m. Eastern start time, Happy Valley. The Buckeyes are the 12-point favorite on the road, total 63 and a hook. The Nittany Lions are plus 320 for an outright victory. Now, this is always a very close game, very close rivalry. Now, the Nittany Lions blew a late fourth quarter lead where all the running back had to do was kneel down short of the goal line and the game would have been over. But instead, he scored, gave Indiana enough time to tie it up, and then the Nittany Lions got robbed in overtime to lose that game. Penn State also they also led a team who completed just 52% of their passes, beat them in that one. And they also allowed three scoring touchdowns on the ground. Meanwhile, offensively, I saw more creativity out of a Pop Warner playbook. Looked like the Lions ran about the same four plays all game. RPO, RPO, design pass, design swing pass, lateral. I mean, couple different looks formation-wise, but for the most part, same plays out of the same formations. Meanwhile, the defense, with an opportunity to seal the deal in that game, they let JV quarterback Michael Penix drive about 70 yards down the field in the final minutes of the game to send it to overtime. Penix would have had a tough time making the East Stroudsburg State roster with the way he was throwing the ball for most of that contest. He was not impressive. But anyway, Penn State's taking on an Ohio State team who is very impressive. They destroyed Nebraska by the final of 52-17. They outscored the Cornhuskers 28-3 in the second half to help blow them out. Now, quarterback Justin Fields was near flawless, 20 for 21 passing, 95% completion percentage, two touchdowns through the air. Fields also rushed for 54 yards and scored on the ground as well. He had two receivers with over 100 yards on the day. That was wideout Garrett Wilson, who had seven grabs for a buck 29 and a touchdown. Wilson actually averaged nearly 19 yards of reception. And of course, no surprise here. You probably heard the name before, but of course, wide receiver Chris Olave had six catches for 104 yards. Olave averaged 17 yards a catch himself. Meanwhile, defensively, Buckeyes looked pretty sound. They got to the quarterback three times and forced two turnovers. Linebacker Pete Werner led the charge defensively with seven tackles on the day. Now, Ohio State's won eight out of their last 10 head-to-head meetings against Penn State. They've absolutely owned them over the past decade, and they're also 5-1 straight up in their last six in Happy Valley. Now, total-wise, four out of the Buckeyes' last five meetings with the Nittany Lions stayed under the post in number. So with all that said and done, I'm going to go ahead and lean toward the Ohio State Buckeyes minus 12 and the under 63.5 in that ball game. And with that, guys, we're going to dive into our quick pick recap, once again brought to you by Patreon.com/BrockPage. I like